Coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
I'm going to try to be as professional as I can today and try to hit all these balls that are getting shot out of this pitching machine at us. Something I haven't covered the last few days, only focusing on Ebola, or mainly focusing on Ebola and the economy and things like that, is Ferguson and St. Louis have blown up. More cops have been shot. More protesters have been shot, one being killed 2 days ago. And now angry protesters target, quote, wealthy whites, vandalize homes, burn U.S. flags, assault reporters, call for officers' death. So this is just absolutely spiraling out of control. And the photos and videos of the flag burning and all the rest of it is just over the top. So we're going to get into some of that today, where our reporters obviously were on the ground in the middle of all that. And quite frankly, we saw a lot of bad behavior by the protesters and a lot of bad behavior by the police. But the feds posing as saviors when they gave the police the training. But now, the last few weeks, the police are getting shot at and shot. And that's escalating things. So I would expect to see looters being killed. And more, the looters are giving the First Amendment a very, very bad name, to say the least. Again, that's just a side note. I haven't covered that. I've been remiss. I have a tendency, when I've got something so giant and so massive, to not talk about it. And I've tried to psychoanalyze what that is. And it's because I don't feel like I can properly break down how big something is until we've put it on paper as an article on Infowars.com or PrisonPlanet.com. Dr. Edward Group is one of the most successful supplement nutraceutical formulators in the country. And he helps us formulate our line for InfowarsLife.com. And he said he could come in. He flew into Austin late last night. He was in Las Vegas for the big internal research, medical, nutraceutical trade show, the supply side event, biggest one in the country, for supplement development. And there were just medical doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, just crawling all over the place. But really, they had impromptu breakaway meetings. And he met with multiple senior level, current and former Border Patrol agents and ICE agents, and then had dinner with them. He was there for days. And the information he just gave us is that there are people coming in, and it's actually in the news today, strangely enough, that they're getting people coming in from West Africa that are sick, but they won't say what they have. Obviously, folks, West Africa has hundreds of millions of people. Nigeria's got like 200-something million alone in it. They're all trying to basically get out of the country. Most countries have shut down their borders. U.S. General, of course, warned days ago it could cross the U.S. border. Southcom, they've got all of Central and South America on their hands, up into Southern North America, Mexico. Northcom's U.S. up into Canada, up into Alaska and the North Pole. And they told him, they said, listen, no, there's people coming up vomiting. The Border Patrol thinks they have Ebola. And it's the first time the Border Patrol's ever worked with the CDC. The CDC doesn't even want it known that it's a full-on emergency. And that they actually are responding. The first time they've ever seen them, hundreds of vans, black and white vans. And there are people in full hazmat suits just grabbing these people, throwing them in them, disappearing. And the Border Patrol's where they're going. They're supposed to put that down under federal law. They just go, don't worry about it. And there's just vans everywhere. And so we're going to send reporters down to the hot zones I want to send Biggs right now. He loves a challenge. So whoever wants to volunteer to a camera person to go with him, whether it's John Bowne or Josh Owens or whoever wants to go, saddle up. We got intel where to send you.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor. Just won't quit.
When cells become toxic, they die early and aging sets in. No one has put together a formula that focuses directly on brain health, nerve growth factors, and optimizing your cellular energy at the same time. Just one of the key compounds, BioPQQ, is backed by major clinical studies. You want the best that's out there at the lowest price anywhere? We now have the synergistic solution. Secure your DNA force today at InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
We let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
A popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assaulting us.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun. You can feel it.
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality.
Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
Tell folks how you got introduced to Super Male, and then when Super Female came out, tell us what happened.
After I saw such a huge positive change in my husband, I had to try it for myself.
Talk about the effects.
I feel great when I wake up in the morning. I have drive to go to the gym. I feel like I look better. I feel better. I feel sexier. I love it.
Even if you don't believe in supplements, take the challenge. Get a bottle of Super Male, a bottle of Super Female. Check it out for yourself. Consult your physician. Visit InfoWarsLife.com today. This is life-changing.
Frontal assault on the lies of the New World Order. It's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Dr. Edward Group is joining us in studio in the next hour. He just returned from a giant insider, biggest in the country, trade convention on supplements in Las Vegas. He met with current and former senior members of the Border Patrol and ICE that were there trying to research Ebola. And they also talked about Zach Taylor. So he came in and said, one of the names we have to look into is Zach Taylor. He's confirmed a lot of this. We pulled up a video minutes ago during the break of Zach Taylor, the former deputy head of the Border Patrol, the head of the Border Patrol Union, now the head of the former Border Patrol Union. He's been on the broadcast talking about the plan to collapse the country, collapse the border, asymmetrical warfare. He's confirming that the Border Patrol already knows that they believe they're finding cases of Ebola on the border. As Southcom came out 2 days ago and said they believe is going to happen. They're getting ahead of it because they know the Border Patrol is leaking the information to warn the American people because overall it's a loyal federal agency and one of the few that's constitutional. If you read the Constitution, the government's supposed to issue the money and control the border and have a Navy. But his sources, and he's going to be in studio with us in the second hour. Paul Watson's doing an article right now. Have witnessed people with Ebola-like symptoms, vomiting, blood coming out of their rear ends, blood coming out of their eyes, coming across from West Africa and the Middle East, and they are being scooped up by CDC, huge teams of vans. They've never before even seen the CDC down there. And the word is, oh no, the CDC's responding. They just don't want to panic. That's why they're saying everything's fine. And that they are scooping people up left and right on the Texas, New Mexico, Arizona, and California border. That is scary. And groups back there, and here's some of the names. I don't use this name. You can use that name. And one of the people they said that we should talk to, Zach Taylor, he's got other sources. And I go, Zach Taylor? And I ran over here and I said, what's the name of the guy we have on who was the former head of the Border Patrol, deputy head of the Border Patrol, and then the head of the union? Oh, that's Zach Taylor. Yeah, Zach Taylor. So we need to try to get him on. And then Watson comes up and goes, have you seen this? This is a CDC release admitting they're going to have sealed plastic coffin liners that can hold up to four dead bodies for an Ebola outbreak. And remember what they store outside the CDC in Atlanta was the millions of plastic coffins that they then scooped up and hid. I did a whole TV show with Jesse Ventura on that. And we even talked about Ebola, if I remember correctly, being one of the reasons. Unbelievable. This is all about to break at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. It's breaking here on the radio, but we're putting it together in text form, and it'll be out in the next hour, a basic report. Watson will then expand on it. They're all in their meeting right now. So this is all unfolding. Now, obviously, this is very, very serious news. And on the backdrop of this, we have the headline, illegal immigration jumps for third straight year under Obama, while Jay Johnson, says Americans are susceptible to claims that we have an open, porous border. Well, we see the Border Patrol being ordered to give them vouchers and load the illegals with their families onto buses to go anywhere they want. We see the illegals getting free health care everywhere. I'm not even against the individuals fleeing hellish third world conditions, except they're used as political tools. But let's be honest, this is going on. And the fact that you keep denying it only discredits you. That's Jay Johnson in CNS News and the Washington Times. While they let the planes fly in, while airport workers in New York and other major cities, LaGuardia and other areas, are refusing to work and refusing to clean the planes, and now TSA people are starting to go off the job because they don't want to be touching people when they make other flight connections coming in from countries that are collapsing. Six countries, two of them near collapse. Estimated 1.4 to 5 million to get Ebola. They can't go anywhere else. They can't go to neighboring African countries. Those have been sealed. The Liberian president seeks more power to fight virus, restrict movement and public gatherings, which is what you've got to do to stop something like this. And our government at one level lets them fly in, but then we talk to the Border Patrol and we've confirmed what group is telling us. He just got in last night from Las Vegas, and the Border Patrol senior people are there hyperventilating, meeting with all these medical doctors and researchers and saying, you know, is there something that we can counter this? Is there something we can get? So we're going to codify all this information, get it into an article in the next hour that Paul Watson is working on that'll break at Infowars.com. And PrisonPlanet.com. But I've got the red siren. The red siren is in here going today, a la DrudgeReport.com, because this whole situation is so incredibly volatile. And that's how government operates, is in a schizophrenic fashion. The Coast Guard's trying to board ships and check to see if people are coming in from West Africa. That's default position, what you're supposed to do. The Marines are training for Ebola outbreaks in containing areas. That's what you're supposed to do. Meanwhile, anything Obama directly controls,